pinche AFL, cabrones. Exodus Productions. Raza for life, Tony Kappo. It's official. I'ma go hard on this beat, cause all of these putos is weak. Fuck all that talking, the puertas are sparking, I'm putting them ratas to sleep.
Richie Valens, La Bamba, watching that movie back when I was a kid, you know, seeing him sing La Bamba on stage and just rocking out, you know. I think that's one of my earliest memories of, you know, wanting to do something like that. Well, of course, Tupac, he's one of my, you know, biggest inspirations as far as music goes, but there was a lot of other artists too, you know, some that aren't so well known, but, you know, a lot of Chicano rap artists, you know, from the pioneers, you know, like Nino Brown, you know, back then they called him O'Genius, Capone, and Kid Frost, you know, were some of my first early introductions to Chicano rap. Well, I started rapping when I was a teenager, just, you know, writing down rhymes in my book, but, like, really taking it seriously, I would say probably about 2006. Well, started rapping with some of my friends that I went to school with. You know, one of my friends would make beats on the table and we just, you know, hit the record button on a tape player or something like that and just bust some freestyles. And as things started getting serious, you know, we found people around the city that had studios and they would help us out and put our music on, like beats and all that stuff. When it comes to writing, man, I got an older cousin who wrote music, and one thing he told me when he used to write music that really stuck out to me was that, like, he never forced himself to write. So he never just sat down and was like, okay, I'm gonna write a song. So a lot of times what I'll do is I'll just put on a beat, and, you know, whatever mood I'm in and whatever type of beat it is, you know, I'll just start putting some things together, and I usually write it in my head and then I'll put it down on paper.
I'm gonna hit him again. First 48 murder on my enemigos.
As far as shows goes, man, I've done quite a few. One of my first shows ever was right here in town, you know, in my hometown. We did a show back in the MySpace days. We got hit up by a promoter on there, and I went there and did my first show, and it actually went pretty good. I was nervous as hell, but I mean, the crowd responded really well, and that kind of gave me a little feel for, you know, how to handle that stage and stuff like that. But as far as shows, I've done a lot of shows. I went from shows where there've been like no people to, like, you know, maybe a couple hundred thousand, maybe at the most. But yeah, definitely done quite a few shows. You know, man, I just want to do shows, man. Like, you know, any place that wants to have me, anybody that wants to invite Raza for life, we'll be there. You know, the next show we got, we'll be doing in Atlanta, Georgia. It's called The Last Invasion. I'll be sharing the stage with legendary Chicano rapper Conejo and Capone, and two guys that I looked up to, you know, and, you know, through this rap shit, I've gotten lucky enough to meet them and, you know, ink the deal with Raza for Life. And, you know, this is our first show that we're all doing together, and from there, you know, we got a couple other bookings in the near future, and as soon as those come out, I'm definitely post that up on social media. I would say, like, the ones I'm most proud of are the ones that I did with you know, A-Pop. Those were some of my favorite videos. You know, we had a lot of fun, a lot of people came out to support us. Some of those videos ain't all available, but, you know, you can still find a couple of them on YouTube. Just check out A-Pac La Familia. But those are some of my favorite videos, man. Good times. The one I would probably be most proud of would be, I'm saying, just that video just captures, like, everything at that time with everybody that was around us. And, you know, working with Compound Films was great. You know, he taught us a lot of stuff and really helped put our vision together. But yeah, I would say I'm saying, you know, it's an older video, but that's probably one of my favorite ones. You should definitely check out the Raza for Life freestyle. You know, we just dropped that one, you know, well, not just dropped it, it came out a few months ago, but definitely, you know, doing pretty good. And that's probably, if you really want to see the type of caliber of rapper I am, that's the video to check out. Well, right now, you know, I got a bunch of music that we've already done. We've just been sitting on it. A lot of it hasn't really officially been released. But right now, we're just working on singles and putting out videos and, you know, hoping to, you know, gain some traction and, you know, get the support behind it. Besides music, you know, just being a dad, you know, taking care of my kids and my family and, you know, making sure everybody's straight. Well, as far as music, man, I'm always working with Exit Door Productions. Those are always my go-to people for production and mixing and mastering. But, you know, other than that, I got Kappo. I got a track I just did with the artist out of West Covina, California. Claws looking pretty dope. I got a track with Frisco Sinatra out of Holland. You know, I got a lot of features with different artists, you know, locally that I have not put out yet. But those are some of the ones that I'm more excited for people to peep out. Don't let the people around you influence you too much. You know, you don't want to take everybody's criticism and you know what they have to say about what you should be doing. Don't take it to heart. Always be open-minded. Listen to what they got to say, but at the end of the day, do what you feel is the type of music that you want to make. You know, speak about what you feel you want to touch on. Other than that, man, don't get too big-headed. Stay humble and, you know, take advantage of every opportunity, man, no matter how little or how small. Man, I can't tell you how many times that I was just like, man, I'm just going to make this call, or I'm just going to show up to the show. And, you know, you shake hands and you make the right impression with the right people, man, that could be your big break. Don't let that pass you up. Well, I'm going to be 100% honest, man. I kind of stole the name. You know, when I was in high school, there was a kid by the name of Anthony Maybax. You know, shout out to Anthony Maybax. I hope you don't mind me dropping his whole fucking government name. But anyways, he was sitting in class with me. And on his journal, you know, I see that he wrote raps. And we started talking about how we both write raps. And he had, it said Kappo Lansky, and I've heard of a Kappo before, but I never really knew what it was, and how he had it spelled was K-O-P-P-O. And I was like, man, that's pretty cool. And I asked him about it, and he broke it down to me and explained to me what a Kappo was and who Lansky was. And I kind of ran with it, and I told him, but I was like, hey, you know, I kind of like that, man. And he was like, do you mind if I use it? And he said, no, go ahead, man, rock with it. And, next thing you know, that's how Tony Kappo was born. And, you know, shout out to the original Kappo Lansky, you know, but that's who I got my name from, man. And, you know, I always got to give credit where it's due. So shout out Anthony Baybacks on the name. Man, I still run into him every now and then. And first thing he highlights is, yo, Kappo. So, you know, it's all love, man. You know, Tony Kappo, man. Shouts out to Anthony Maybach. Man, my number one favorite movie, I'm going to keep it 100. It's got to be Blood In, Blood Out. You know, followed up by La Bamba and then American Me. The top three. You know, I probably watched every one of those movies 100 times and can quote every line in them. So if you ain't seen those ones, definitely check them out. Number one recommendations. Man, that ain't even hard to answer. I'd go with Tupac, man. Just everything about Pac's music is just fucking incredible to me. Man, tacos. Can't go wrong with tacos, man. Oh, man, just hearing good beats, you know what I'm saying? Hearing hot production and other rappers, you know what I'm saying? Like, that really is what pushes me to, you know, try to spit some hot shit and, you know, make some music that's fucking dope, you know? I like to say that I do get influenced by other artists, you know? Just seeing these guys go hard makes me want to go even harder, so that's where I kind of get my inspiration and drive from. Shit, 2019, man, we just hope to, you know, consistently drop a video a month, two videos a month, you know, just give you guys, you know, as much music as possible, and then, you know, continue to hit the road and doing shows and, you know, spreading the word, letting people know about Tony Kappo and Raza for Life and the whole camp. We also got a blog coming out with Exit Door Productions, myself and MCI, so stay tuned for that, man. Definitely a lot of behind the scenes footage of us, you know, working on music, shooting videos, just chopping it up about, you know what I'm saying, music and different subjects. So, you know, it's not everything's about music, man, but a lot of different content you're going to be able to check out in that blog. So make sure you guys keep on the lookout for that. You know, just keep putting out more music for everybody and hoping they enjoy it and continue to support it and keep growing the fan base and, you know, just stay relevant with what I'm doing and in touch with the culture and holding down this genre of Chicano rap. You know, right now it's a small genre, not very well known, but by that time, definitely going to see a lot more Mexican rappers, you know, Hispanic, Latino, whatever you want to call yourself, on the forefront of this hip hop shit. Cause you know, we've been there since the beginning. So we're definitely part of the legacy. Why these rappers so mad though? Man, shouts out to Rasa for Life. Shouts out to Capone, 7-4 Visuals, the homie Chilla Patilla. Shouts out to MCI and Exodore Productions and everybody that's behind me and, you know, holding me down. And shouts out to all the taco stands in Muskegon. Jesus on my necklace, eat chorizo with my breakfast. I stay true, don't test us. Kappo status, apocalypto. Ride around with that loaded pistol, leave a puto leaking if you got an issue.